children of all ages, welcome to the great Danbury State Fair Revue. Opening the show tonight is an original song and video done by Dave King, a local musician and artist.
Danbury Fair. back, relax. Do be aware, there are two fire exits, one behind you and one to your right. And really, you're not here to see me, you're here to see the show, so enjoy.
To promote business in the Danbury area, and the Danbury Fair was born. Billy, give us some insight as to what the popular music was at the time.
Well, we have to think that we're talking about the Civil War era, and there were some popular songs that were old even then. And our friend Mike Solden, extraordinary vocalist, is going to give you a little background of the song, and then we're going to sing it.
Well, most people are familiar with this classic song. The songwriter John Newton was an 18th century British slave trader who had a dramatic faith experience during a storm at sea. He gave his life to God, he left the slave trade, became a pastor, and wrote hymns. For the rest of his life, he played a significant role in the movement to abolish the slave trade. It has been estimated that this song, Amazing Grace, is performed around the world about 10 million times a year.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but
singing. So anyway, last year when this event was just starting to get organized, of his father had, and he discovered this interesting bottle here. And it said, Moses Dames Wine of the Woods. So I did a little research, and it turns out in the history of Danbury of Charles Ives, Ike Ives was his uncle who dabbled in the snake oil sales business. And it's mentioned in the Charles Ives biography that Wine of the Woods was sold at the Danbury Fair by Ike Ives. So last year when we found this, we considered it an omen that this event must take place and this has to be on our stage.
Thank you, Will. They swore to us that stuff was completely non-alcoholic. Billy, what was the music that accompanied the turn of the 19th century?
Well, it was a song called, I'm not going to tell you what the song was called, but I misquoted something. The song we're about to do is the closing credit of the Ken Burns song, not the last one, not the 1862 song. It's the 1898. This is the Spanish-American War era. Teddy Roosevelt has got the Rough Riders in Cuba. They played this song so many times that the people there think it's the American national anthem. And it was a rather risque song at the time. So I think you'll enjoy it.
After the ball.
ring-walking exhibitions, motorcycle, soccer, and auto racing featuring nationally known drivers. In 1922, on the last day of the fair, the old wooden grandstand burned down. It was quickly replaced with a new steel and concrete building, which would stand until the fair ended.
Why is it thinking so fast? I start getting dreamy when you start talking. I'm thinking about all these things that happened there. So, Jack brings us into the 1920s, and for us to come up with songs, where is the best representative? So, we came up with a song that many of us know. We know by another artist. But this song was a mega hit in America in 1928 is the year that the palace opened, so it has special relevance. It's also relevant because when you were at the Danbury Fair, every merry-go-round carousel had it on a calliope. This is a song that was played when we were kids going round and round. And it has one more significant aspect. The man who wrote it, his name, is the same name as the man that owns the Sycamore Restaurant in Bethel. Gene Austin